To make this project, you'll need two boards. This is the receiver board, ESP32 board, and that's the transmitter board. So to drive the motor, the DC motor, we need this driver, this DC motor driver, L298N DC motor driver. Okay, we're gonna need a bunch of wires. Okay, so we are driving a 6-volt DC motor. So I'm going to connect this wire to the ground of this of the receiver board. Okay, the receiver board and the driver and the receiver board, they will share the same ground. So the yellow wire is attached to GPIO4. GPIO4 will control the DC motor through our DC motor driver, L298N DC motor driver. Moving ahead, so right now we need to attach the black wire to this connector. Okay, the middle connector is the ground. Okay, ground connector. So the ESP32 board and the driver, they will share the same ground. So I'm attaching the GPIO4 to input pin in 4 of the DC motor driver. So we need a 7.2 volt external power supply. The positive side of this power supply is going to connector plus 12 volt. Now we close, and the negative side of the ground of the external power supply will be sharing the same ground, okay, with ESP32 board and the driver itself. Okay, so moving forward, the setup is almost done. Okay, this time, as I connected the GPIO to input 4, so we should connect. We must connect the DC motor to output 1 and output 3 and 1. Like that. Okay. And I'm going to connect the black wire on this side of the breadboard on this side, okay? Like that. So we don't need to connect any stuff to GPS to transmitter board. Okay, so now the cables, okay, for receiver board and the transmitter board, so we can upload the sketches. Okay, we connect. So I forgot to connect this wire to the ground, the blue rail, okay, so that they can share the same ground, the ESP32, the driver, and the external power supply. Okay, now we can go to Arduino ID. So this is the code, and you need to include, okay, this is the sender code, okay, and the code is well explained, okay. I'm going to provide the code in the description of this video, okay. I commented the code, okay, so that you guys can understand, okay, what each line is doing, okay, the variables, so all this stuff, okay, so you're going to get it, okay. So for instance, that's this function, so I explained, okay, so it will be used, it is for you to understand. So if you find an issue, you can leave a comment, okay. So everything here, so you can just read to understand, because if you are idle, the things ain't go well for you. So I explained everything, okay. So if you read this comment, you will understand. So now we go to receiver code. Also the same thing, I commented every stuff here, so the structure, the variables, okay, my data variable or an instance, okay, the my data variable, yeah, and also the last data received time, I explained. This is the DC motor driver, the GPIO 4, okay. So if you read, you're going to understand, okay. So I can't do more than that, okay. So this is the function on data receive, on data, okay, is a callback, okay. That is called da-da-da-da-da, and the setup function, okay, void setup function is called once when the microcontroller starts up, it initializes da-da-da-da-da, the void for loop function, okay, runs repeatedly after the setup is done. So, okay, so you gotta read, okay, you gotta read. So okay, everything well explained, okay guys. So you don't forget to like and subscribe. Now we upload the sketch, okay, which was the port. So that's the sender, the transmitter sketch, okay. Okay, so we are uploading. It takes time, mainly when your laptop is not that expensive, if you want. So compiling, I think I need to cut to be let me see. Okay, I think I'm going to cut to reduce the time, okay guys. So let me do that. I've just edited. So now I need to press the boot button. Press, okay, then you release it. And when it's 100%, you then click on reset button. Now we go to receiver code, we do the same stuff, and we click port. Now is 10, I think, okay, 10, and then we click on upload. So I need also to cut this because it will take time, okay guys. I pause. Here we are again, okay guys. You press the boot button and you release it, and when it's done you press on reset button to reset. So now the test.